Hi, I'm Lily. If you like spending time outdoors and doing activities like hiking, hunting, or geocaching, I know a career that might be a good option for you.
Do you get excited about planning and designing new things? Well, this career would let you do the things you love every day. If you enjoy working with super cool technologies like drones and virtual reality, then this job could be the perfect fit.
And if you're looking for a high-demand outdoorsy job where you can do all these things and maybe even own your own business someday, consider the possibilities in a career in land surveying. What are you waiting for? Let's go. I'd like you to meet Andrea, a land surveyor and owner of Atlas Land Consulting in Basehor, Kansas. Andrea, thanks for meeting with us today to tell us about your job. I know absolutely nothing about what a land surveyor does, but I'm ready to learn.
That's a great attitude. Most kids don't know much about land surveying, but this is a well-paying job that's badly needed right now in Kansas. If you want to learn how to do it, someone will teach you.
Let's dig into that. What exactly do land surveyors do?
Land surveyors are people who measure and map land in both two-dimensional and three-dimensional space.
Why would anyone need their land measured and mapped in the first place?
That's a great question. Land surveyors are professionals who work in many aspects of design, construction, insurance, and sale of buildings. Construction companies need land surveyors to determine where to design locations for buildings and other features like roads, bridges, fences, and utilities. Some surveyors work for construction companies. Engineers who design buildings and other structures need surveyors to create topographic maps of the land they're building on so they can design around the land's features. Government agencies like cities and counties and property owners need land surveyors to establish real estate boundaries for properties. Knowing specific boundaries is especially important when people buy and sell land. And finally, insurance companies sometimes hire land surveyors to determine whether a property could be easily flooded.
Who would have known land surveying was important to so many different situations? So what exactly is involved in measuring the land? I mean, I'm assuming you don't just use a standard tape measure.
Nope. We use tools designed to measure angles and distance while taking into consideration slope, air temperature, and the Earth's circumference. This allows us to produce very precise measurements that your average tape measure can't produce. Instead, we use instruments like this total station.
How does it work?
Let's go set it up and I can show you. I find that's the best way to explain what I do.
Let's do it.
All right. There is a laser that's out of here, and we want to get that laser directly on that point there. And then you're going to use both your hands to move this entire thing to where that laser's right in that spot. A total station is an electronic and optical instrument that measures angles and distances between two points, and the information is stored in this data collector.
I wish I had had one of those before my last geometry test.
I don't know how much it would have helped you, but your teacher sure would have been impressed. This job brings geometry to life.
Andrea told me about the total station and how it communicates with the reflector through lasers you can't see with the naked eye. It measures how long it takes to reflect the laser back to the total station. The station figures into its calculations the height, air temperature, and time it takes to determine the distance. We measured points every 25 feet to map the Atlas parking lot. It was so cool how the total station moves in sync with the reflector. Plus, the reflector kinda looks like a wizard staff, don't you think? Then Andrea had Chance, a drone pilot, show me how they use drones to map larger areas. Using drones save lots of time and can even make their work more safe. The drones also produce much more information than traditional surveying. Thanks, Chance, for letting me fly it.
You're welcome.
So what do you do with all the data once you've collected it?
Let's go inside and I can show you.
Andrea took me into the office and showed me how the computer took the data points from the data collector and turned it into a map of the parking lot. She also showed me a point cloud made from the data from the drone to also make a new map of the entire area around the ALC office.
All right, you just learned your whole first week of surveying.
Okay, now I have a much better understanding of what a land surveyor does, but now I want to learn more about you. How did you get into this type of work?
My dad is a land surveyor and owned his own business, so I've been around it my entire life, but I never saw it as a career for myself. After high school, I went to college and got a bachelor's degree in corporate recreation and wellness, which has nothing to do with land surveying. I graduated in 2009 during the Great Recession, and I couldn't find a job, so my dad offered to give me a job to help me pay my bills.
He taught me everything I needed to know to get started, and I took some additional classes from Kansas City, Kansas Community College. Soon, I fell in love with surveying.
What did you love about it?
I always loved being outdoors, and this job certainly lets me do that. Being a land surveyor is a great job for people who like being paid to walk around outside all day. But when it's really hot or cold or rainy and being outdoors isn't very fun, I can do the office side of my job. Every day is different, so I'm never bored.
When did you start your own company?
I started Atlas Land Consulting in 2021. The best part about working for myself is that I get to create my own schedule, work with who I want to work with, and when I want to work with them. But that comes with trade-offs too. I'm always responsible for working on bidding new projects and putting together proposals. A few years after I opened my business, my dad decided to retire, so I bought out his business and combined our two companies into one. We currently have 15 employees between our survey, engineering, and office staff.
To be honest, I have no idea what I want to be when I grow up, but what you've shown me today seems like an interesting option. If I want a career like yours, what advice would you give me?
Well, in school, I think it's important to take math classes and do well there, specifically geometry and even physics too. Geocaching is a hobby that would teach you a lot of good skills that would come in handy in this field. Plus, I think it's just fun. But when it's time to get a job, there's a couple of ways to learn the skills you need to be a surveyor. You can work for an experienced surveyor who's willing to teach you, or you can go to a community college to learn the basics. Both certificate programs and associate's degrees are available in this field. Kansas City, Kansas Community College has the only program of its kind in the state. Over your career, you'll need to keep learning as the technology is always improving and changing. One of the next advancements in land surveying will be using virtual reality tools to help us place items precisely on a job site. So expect to take some continuing education classes throughout your career. But that's true of most professional careers, not just land surveying.
Thank you. That's helpful information. This seems like a career with a lot of flexibility and a lot of potential.
Yes, it is. The need for surveyors is so great right now that if somebody expresses interest, there are employers out there that are willing to teach you.
I'll definitely add this to my possible careers list. Thank you to Andrea and her team here at Atlas Land Consulting for telling us about land surveying and how it is a needed skill in many different industries. Learn more about this career and other high-demand jobs at HirePaths.com. Until next time, this is Lily signing off in Basehor for Cool Careers. Have a great day. Andrea and her team here at Atlas Land Consulting for telling us about land surveying and how it is a high...
Yeah, we hear you. Go away.
Instead, we use instruments like this total station.
How does it work?
Let's go shut it up. Let's go set it up. Let's go start over.